Hello everybody, and welcome to this tutorial, how to model a ceiling fan with twisted blades like this in Shapr3D in a very, very easy and fast way. I will run you through the basic sketches we have to create and then show you the individual modeling steps we will need to create all the details, and then finish this exercise with a nice material visualization inside Shapr's very easy to use visualization tool. And with all that said, let's get going. Before we get started, let's make sure unit system is set to inches and we have our grid snapping elements turned on. Let's go to your top view. We will create our first basic sketch. A circle at the origin, 5 inches. I will lock the circle so it can't move. And then a center rectangle somewhere along the x-axis on the grid. 20 by 5 inches. Escape. And then from the center point to this left edge, and that should be a distance of 3 inches. Very good. That's awesome. Now again, close, go to transform and move and rotate. Select these two lines, move the widget to the center, turn on copy, and then rotate 2 times, 2 copies, 120 degrees. These two lines here, I don't need anymore, so I can delete them. These lines, I do not want to rotate, so I lock them. Very good. And then I can go ahead and add 2 arcs to fill these areas. To make sure that the arc and this line is 180 degrees, I can add a tangency constraint. There we are. And we can do the same here. Very good. Okay. We have now the circle and the rectangle as a filled profile. The spacing between is empty. To fill this, we just draw a line from the circle center to the centers of the arcs. There we are. Now we have 3 profiles. This is actually now our masterpiece for the blade. We can extrude this one down, 0.2 inches. There we are, very good. I would like this to be twisted, so I hide the sketch. That makes it very easy to select only the geometry. For a concept model, I simply select the back face of the blade, go to move, rotate, and then I rotate this 20 degrees. There we are, you see? It's pretty, very easy. On the right side, very twisted. To the left side, it gets smaller till it is flat. Very good. Seen from the top, I would like this to be more tapered to the right side. Now, this is actually like a masterpiece. And out of this piece, I'm going to cut my new piece. So I will hide this for the moment, turn on the previous sketch, select the circle, select actually this line and this line. And then I make a copy and move this one down to any position. Doesn't really matter where. There we are. Very good. The first sketch we can hide, so it's gone. Now, I select this profile, go to sketch. This then actually moves the grid into the sketch and we are in this perpendicular view. This line here, I don't want to change, so I lock it. Then I draw from here to there a line, escape. This line and this line, horizontal, vertical. This should be 20, that is good. And you should be 4. So this line I drew here by being horizontal kept actually this line centered to this line. Because now look what I can do. I just draw a line at an angle. There we are. Very good. Very simple geometry. So now I will do exactly the same one more time. Move and rotate. I select these edges, move this to the circle, actually, and you see that finds the center point. Very good. Rotate, copy, 120, 120. Very good. These lines should not rotate. So we lock them, and then I go to arc, and draw myself again the arcs right in there. To make this perfect, we create our tangency relationships. There we are. Very good. And then to fill this, there are the lines. Very good. Cool. So now I have these profiles, and let me show you what I can do with this. If I show this, I can extrude this up and cut through, or I can actually do an intersect, and that keeps then the volume of the intersecting volume. But that's not necessarily yet really what I want, because these edges are too small. I need to grow this a little bit. So you see, I selected each surface here and then expanded this. And now I go ahead, do this one more time, cut through and say, keep the intersecting volume. Yeah, beautiful. So that's also then how we make a twisted tapered piece where the sides are actually vertical and not twisted. Very good. Let's add a little bit more of detail to this piece. So these ends here, we can rotate. Sorry, I meant fillet 0.5. Then this edge, and this edge 0.2. And then to fillet all the edges, the easiest way is select the faces, because now when we go to chamfer and type in 0.01, you see it selects all the edges and fillets it for us. Beautiful. Yeah, that's actually how easy it is to model this. So one piece is done. Later we will add screws at the bottom. That's the reason why we don't make copies of this yet. Can continue. We need to build everything that sits on top. So I hide everything, show the sketch. Here, this I extrude up half of an inch. That is the disc onto which the blades will be mounted. On top sits now the engine compartment. So the top face I extrude 4 inches. That fuses everything together. Let's change this to a new body. Here, extrude 10 inches. Also, as a new body, but this should only be a diameter of 1 inch. So you see how I did this. Super fast, no sketches at all. And 2.2 extrusion, new part there. And then this should only be 4 inches instead of 5 inches. Super easy. Those two I can join together with the union command, originals off, because now I can go ahead and say this should be chamfered 0.5. And then all these edges, I will include this one, 0.1, very nice. The top should be open. So I select this shell 0.1, give this a nice thickness. These are very sharp edges. We will fill it 0.01. Very good. Then we can go ahead and select these edges down here, 0.01, and round those two. 0.1. See, we can play with the values while we're inside the command, but we can also always select a fillet 3, for example, 0.05, and adjust the fillet for all afterwards too. So super easy. On top of this face here, right down there, I would like to have a groove. So this part I will hide, or what's also very easy, I select this part and then I go to isolate. And you see everything is gone. I only see this part. I select the top face, go to sketch. There's my central point. Very good. Here's my right edge. Rectangle from here. Right at the edge, I will do a rectangle 0.4 by 0.3. When you zoom in more, you get better snapping options. There we are. Escape. Very good. To exit the isolation mode, we just click on this icon. Now I can go ahead, select this, extrude this one down, So 4 inches, and then this is half of an inch. It shouldn't really cut completely through. So 4.25. There we are. I have two more blades, so I need two more cuts. The easiest way to do this is I extrude this down, 4.25, okay. Double click to select it, move the widget onto the cylindrical surface that finds the center axis, rotate it one more time, and then make a copy and rotate it. There we are. You see, super easy. Now I can select this part, these two, and say subtract, but keep the removed bodies. That's important. So they're still there. And then from this, I would like these two to be removed and none. There. Super easy. Okay. Let's hide our sketch. We can actually, by the way, clean up this design a little bit by moving all the sketches into one folder. And then when we turn the folder on and off, we can see all the parts. There we are. Look at this. This looks actually pretty good already. To bring this to an end, we want to quickly create a representation for screws so we can talk about how the blade will be attached to the base. This is very easy to do. With nothing selected, we go to a side view, turn on section cut, and turn off all these other objects. So this is the base, half of an inch. This is the blade, 0.2 inches. So it's actually very, very good to have something like this as a representation. You can turn this all off. Then I will create a very simplistic screw head this way. So from the center, I go down 0.2, go over 0.2, then I go over 0.05, have 1.05, 0.15, and then go up, go a little bit further up to here, over, and good. Leave it there. And then this point, I move up to here. Very good. So select everything, horizontal, vertical constraint. This point I would like to lock because now I can specify everything. Okay, so from this point, which is, as you can see, right there at the bottom of the blade, this should only go in 0.4 inches. That's perfect. This should only be 0.2 wide. The radius, which later will be the diameter. See, everything I can specify. And then now I can select the profile, select this edge, and say revolve. There's my screw. I would like to adjust the thickness here a little bit so this disc really sits slightly on top of that face there. There you can see the distance. Okay. On this disk, I would like to create a hex nut shape. So select the face, sketch, there's my center point, beautiful, polygon tool, and 0.18, very good. And then in 3D view, we extrude this one down 0.05 or to the specifications you have. And this is basically now a good representation of a screw. Because what we can do now is simply the following. Now we can take a look at proportionally, how does this all look and compare. And we have one piece only right now. I would like to have one here and one there. So double click, go onto the copy command, and then we move this over by 2 inches. Very good. Now, this is centered. I would like this to be somewhere here. I turn off the copy command and then the widget, I move onto the surface here. And you see it snaps to the center. That's the Z axis. And I can rotate this 60 degrees. And while this is rotated, you see also the widget is rotated. And then I can move this back half of an inch. There. That is how easy this is. So let's do this one more time. Make a copy, minus two, turn copy off, bring this over to here, rotate this 60 degrees, and then bring this over minus half of an inch. Very good. This element we can hide. I move the sketch to there. This piece, if we want, can also bring to there. So we're kind of like cleaning up our design a little bit. And I would like to have screw holes. So from this, these two screws, I would like to be subtracted, but keep the removed bodies. Because now, as you can see, look at this. There is everything. Isn't it amazing how easy this is? So with all this actually done, let's hide the isolation mode. We can turn all this on, and actually we could very quickly select this, this, and this, and then go to the move and rotate command there. Copy 120 and 120 there. Very good. So really easy. So I work actually only on 1/3 and do all the work then later via copies. To bring everything to an end, let's quickly add some materials to all the parts inside the visualization tool. But before we do this, I would like to create a little bit of an organization. So these three blades I will put into one folder. Then I have here my three other elements. I put those into one folder, and then I have all my screws. I put those into one folder. Very good. So now when we go to the visualization tool, the first thing what I would like to do is let's go to environment, and then we turn off the ground plane. This is actually under the ceiling, so we don't really have a drop shadow there. Here are my individual objects. I have them also here. And everything above the blades, I would like to be brushed titanium. So I will go to metal, scroll down till I see brushed titanium. And then I can drag this onto that folder and take a look at this. All the pieces inside get that material. Isn't it amazing? Here are my screws. I can also drag a material directly onto an object, or again, I drag this onto the folder and give this all objects inside that folder. Huge, huge shortcut. Now, the blades will be interesting because we have actually two different materials. We have a top and a bottom, and then a wood material. So let's go to wood. And here is the sanded birch, like a clear coat, and then drag this over to there. Very good. And this way I get all the material onto the edges. Very nice. But the top faces, I would like to be a different material. And take a look at what I'm doing. I just select all those six faces. Then I see here in the property that I can change that material, change, and then we will give those a melamine material. There we are. And then we adjust this color to be something like a nice bright white. Very good. You see, super easy. Let's go back to environment. Let's give this a nice colored background. We can adjust also here the color, for example. There we are. Very good. Zoom in a little bit more so we could highlight all the individual interesting, nice details. And then to create an image, we simply click capture. And that is how easy it is to create actually a nice product presentation with the materials inside Shapr's visualization tool.